have with us Bishop Parajuli. Sir, I would like to know, if we talk of sustainable development or SDGs, so what do you think for now, how much India have achieved this goal?
Well, India wishes to achieve the SDG target before time. In fact, it has been putting many elements to achieve those targets. In the context of poverty reduction, it has made a lot of impact. In the context of zero hunger, it has several programs. In the context of universal health care, etc., also it has lots of program. On climate change issues, it's working quite extensively. India hosted a COP14, and also there are several initiatives. So indeed, however, there are also challenges because the issue is India is prone to natural disasters. They say it's one of the fifth largest victim of those natural disasters. So as a result, it affects people, it affects communities, and also there are, although efforts to reduce emission, but this is, India is still the third largest emitter of carbon. And therefore, the engagement with science and technology to have like electric, vehicles or use of green energy is important. And India is almost a leader on that. In fact, it has the Solar Alliance system. And I would also say that India, as one of the biggest economy and the vision of being its 5 trillion economy, is a leader on many fronts. So it can also contribute in terms of addressing SDG as a partner and friend to other countries as well. And what I was particularly focusing on as a United Nations World Food Programme representative in India is the challenge of hunger globally. 981 million, and then one in three children being still malnourished, and the zero hunger implication is interlinked to poverty. It's interlinked to health. It's linking to education, climate change, decent job, etc. So, stressing on these multiple factor is fundamental and key. And also, I was sharing our cooperation with Government of India last 50 years of partnership, and how we are trying to bring best practices, technologies, and knowledge to support improve on many of the efforts Government of India has launched. Like, for example, in the context of public distribution system, which is one of the largest in the world, about 800 million people receiving food support, to make sure how to target it best to avoid leakage and etc. And the same way, in the context of other program, to have the food and etc. have a nutrition component needed. And other factors such as reduction in losses, because globally 1/3 of the production is lost, and that's a very sad thing. And then the other aspect is the issue of addressing malnutrition. How do we really work together in reducing malnutrition in India, which is seem to be a challenge, and government really committed and seeking good partnership across. So there, the engagement of private sector in producing diversified food, and also continuing improving access of food, increasing income for the farmers, linking market to production center, are very important. And the other aspect is the, right now we're talking about in Spain, a global leader sitting together and to see how to reduce carbon emission. And in Delhi here, we have this pollution. So how do we really zero into our practical life? India has done so much in terms of reducing loss of life to almost zero caused by natural disasters and other things. But in simple way, these things are important to address, like air pollution. And similarly, to be sustainable in production, use water more responsibly, and we have alternative crops which really don't overuse water, plant more trees, and be responsible in consumption, as Mahatma Gandhi used to say from long time. So these are good things.
You explained really well, sir, and I think you touched almost all the points. So I think we will hope these goals certainly in future. Thank you so much for talking with Tenny, sir.
Thank you so much. And one of the really good part of this today's conversation is there were several CEOs, innovative corporates, who have the solution and who have good commitment to join in government, public, to address some of these issues. And another good thing is the government's initiative of this whole CSR is a brilliant step, which brings government to be sustainable, the private sector to be sustainable, corporate to be sustainable, and joining in with government and civil society and others in helping community, society, addressing the Sustainable Development Goal. Broadly, the whole SDG is focused on five areas. It's people, prosperity, planet, peace and partnership. And therefore, the discussion today really touched on all these five points, and I was very pleased to be part of it, sharing a practical example how UN World Food Program has been working to address hunger in partnership with Government of India. Thank you very much. Thank you.